surely I'm going away. So you open the door, I'm going away. While I'm waiting, I'll be worshiping. While I'm waiting, I'll be praising. While I'm waiting, I'll be praising. While I'm waiting, I'll be praising. It's about what you do when you wait. Why complain when you can pray? It's not about just waiting. It's about what you do when you're waiting. So instead of complaining, why don't we just start praising in the middle of the stuck end? I'm waiting, I'll be praising.
Though the earth may pass away, your word remains the same. Good afternoon, everyone. We would like to extend our condolences to the family of Bria. And right now, we would like to begin the tributes as we have commenced viewing. The family has requested that we respect their privacy by not taking any pictures, and please no touching. So let us kindly work with the family as they go through this very difficult time. Thank you very much. For anyone who wishes to come and render your selection or your item during this time, you are free to do so. Again, tributes have begun.
I still bless you.
nothing I can do to let you down. It doesn't take a trophy to make you proud. I'll never be more loved than I am right now. Yeah.
say? What do you say? If you say they are daughters, I will trust. What do you say? What do you say? If you say we're children of the Most High,
what
trust
you say?
Yeah.
What do you say?
If you say my mother will be healed, I will trust.
What you say?
Yeah.
What you say?
If you say my father will be delivered from alcohol, I trust.
What you say?
Yeah.
What you say?
If you trust my sister will be delivered from depression, I say.
What you say?
Yeah.
What you say?
You will keep all your promises. We trust.
What you say?
We trust.
What you say?
We trust what you say. Still speaking. So glad you're still speaking. You're still revealing and you're still fulfilling. You're still revealing and you're still fulfilling. We will walk in what you say. We will live in what you say. If you said it, we will see. We believe. Yeah. What you say.
Satisfy this craving, Jesus, Jesus.
There's a lovesick longing deep inside my soul. There's a desperate hunger that won't let me go.
Good afternoon, everybody. This afternoon, I'll try to sing a song in honor of the life of miracle. All right, bear with me, please. Ready? Be one water. How can I forget the times you held my hand and wiped the tears from my eyes? How can I forget? Oh yeah. And when I needed someone, you were right by my side. I know you had to be an angel in the sky, sent from God to bring joy to my life. And now you've gone back home, and I want you to know I still hear your voice, I still feel her touch. And when I close my eyes, I can see her smile. And though she's gone away to a better place, I can't wait to be with her after. Sometimes I break down, but I accept God's will in spite of the way I feel. Sometimes I wish that I can take her place.
She's gone away to a better
just to see her face again. After a while, just to feel her touch again. After a while. Thank you.
Good afternoon. Now, I had to put the word good in front of afternoon because it's customary and it's manners. So, afternoon, everybody. It's not really a good afternoon, but in everything, we got to give thanks, yeah? So, I'm supposed to be up here to pray, but I didn't give a tribute, so I just want to be able to have a few moments, if you would indulge me, so I can speak. I want to speak this afternoon on peace. I think it's 329 times in the Bible the word peace is mentioned. They said the highest occurrence is in the book of Isaiah 30 times. Be not afraid or fear not is mentioned 365 times in the Bible. Jesus said, peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you, not as the world gives do I give to you. So let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. 365 times. We are admonished not to be afraid. 329 times we are told about peace. So this afternoon my prayer is about peace. And there's a perfect peace that they talk about in the Bible. Peace that passes all understanding, and it comes from the Prince of Peace. And I want to encourage everybody today to try to find peace, whatever that is for you, however that is, peace. At the beginning of the year, we, at our church, we had to pick fruits of the Spirit. And I was away for that event, but someone picked for me. And the thing that I got was peace. And I forgot about it, but that's something I've been pursuing a lot lately. And I was cleaning up my bag the other day, and I saw the little satchel that had the word peace in it. And a lot of us sometimes take it for granted, but it's one of the single most important things we will ever hope to have in this life, is peace. Let us pray. Father God, thank you. Thank you for life, your love, and your peace, God. God, you are a good God, even though sometimes some not so good things happen. You are still a good God. I remember Job in the Bible when he says that you give and you take away. He came into this world naked, and naked he was going to leave. blessed be your name. And today, God, we bless your name. God, we thank you for the life and the little legacy of Bria Miracle Arthurton. God, we thank you, and I thank you that I know and I've gotten to know this little girl in such a place that she holds such a major piece of my heart. I thank you for the time that I have had with her. I thank you for the interactions, the little, her little sharp mouth at times, her dancing, her smiling, her singing, and all the wonderful memories. God, today I bring before you the family, the friends, all of us who are here today, God, to celebrate her life and to support each other. God, I pray that you bring comfort to Kenricia and her family, to Dion and his. God, I pray for the uncles. I pray for Prince, especially, God, and Nene, that they find comfort and they find peace, God, and they get to know you in a way that will truly touch their lives and change their lives in a miraculous way. God, may we use the life and legacy of this young lady to be drawn closer to you, God. We know these are times that are tough and they're challenging, and sometimes we don't even want to hear or know that you understand and that you know best. But God, we trust you. God, we trust you, we trust you, we trust you. When we don't understand, we trust you. When it doesn't make sense, we trust you. When we don't agree, God, we trust you. Because we know that somewhere along the line, one day by and by, we'll understand it. So God, for all of us here today, I pray your perfect peace, God. That peace that passes all understanding, God. I pray that that peace rests on everyone's heart, those who are here and those who are abroad, who are on the live stream. God, give us your peace. God, we need your peace more than ever now. Still our troubled hearts, God, let us not be afraid. Let us lean on you. We ask for these things with thanksgiving. In the name of your son, Jesus, amen. KK and crew, Bria has found her peace. I am finding mine. I hope you find yours.
Pleasant good afternoon to all. Let's all stand, please. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword, as it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long, and we are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Bless the Lord. At this time, Mr. Virgil Hodge would come and do a service. Huh? Okay. Mr. Sorry. Sorry.
Good afternoon, church. Just want to send my condolences to Bria's family. And this song is dedicated to Bria from her mom.
bless the Lord. Let's stand now and do this congregational hymn. When he cometh to make up his jewels, all his jewels, precious jewels, his loved and his own.
When he cometh to make up his jewels, all his jewels, precious jewels.
Chapter 10, reading from 13 to 16. Mayor Isaac will come and read for us today.
Good afternoon, church. The scripture reading is taken from Mark 10, 13 to 14. And they brought young children to him, that he should touch them, and his disciples rebuked those that brought them. But when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, Suffer the little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein. And he took them up in his arms, put his hands upon them, and blessed them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. May the Lord continue to add his blessings to the reading of his word. The second scripture will be taken from St. Matthew chapter 18, reading from verse 1 to 6. Caitlin Hobson will do that one for us.
Good afternoon, church. The scripture reading is taken from Matthew chapter 18, verse 1 to 6. At that time, the disciples came to Jesus and asked him, Who then is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? He called a little child to him and placed the child among them. And he said, truly I tell you, unless you change and become like a little child, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, whoever takes the lowly position of this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me. If anyone causes one of these little ones, those who believe in me, to stumble, it will be better for them to have a large millstone hung around their neck and not to be drowned in the depths of the sea. Thank you.
Bless the Lord. We can be assured that these words, they are settled. The word says, his words, they are settled in heaven. It's time for a tribute section in the program for this afternoon. I don't think the first one on the program should be the Prime Minister. I don't think I saw him here, see him here. So we'll roll on. Do we have blessings? Dekia here? Okay, could you come and do your item first, and then we'll flow accordingly. Libard, then the Conway Football Club, and then the godparents.
Good afternoon. So we are going to sing this song on behalf of Brianna and her family. And we hope that her mom, of course, that you will find peace. And so this is for you.
Somewhere beyond the clouds, I can feel heaven. sunshine somewhere beyond the clouds. I can feel a heaven.
Bless the Lord. We want to acknowledge the presence of the Honorable Prime Minister, Dr. Terence Jewell, this afternoon here in our midst. We're going to give him, he is scheduled to do one of the tributes, but we'll let him cool off, seeing he just get here, and we'll go down to Kamoi Libert to come and do that tribute at this time.
Good afternoon. My tribute is a poem by Caresia Georges in honor of Bria. Miracle's purpose. While she entered the world with a loud entrance, she captured the attention of everyone at once, caused memorable interactions here and there. Bria was the bright of the light to calm any fear. She was funny and smart and a little cutie too. She'd leave everyone in awe who viewed her many photo shoots, not realizing she was creating memories for all. For a day like today, she orchestrated teardrops fall. Bria's now an angel that gained her wings. She did her path on earth, now in heaven she sings. She'll be missed by many, both near and far. Baby Bria served her purpose, boy shine us who we are. A brother's keeper, a sister to the end, our sweet baby girl caused so many hearts to mend. God knew we need an intervention in humanitarianism. Baby Bria did that and delivered the most compassionate mission.
Thank you very much. Could we have the Economy Football Club at this time, please, coming and doing their tribute?
Good afternoon, Church. Honorable Prime Minister, Dr. Terence Jewell, parents of Miracle, family and friends of Bria. Miracle became a family not just to a community, not just a nation, but to the world. Her story taught us much, which is not limited to the fight. We are much stronger than we think. So when life throws its uncertainties, we must be resilient. So on behalf of the Conway Football Club, we wish to render this tribute in song, which is so fitting. Great is thy faithfulness by Mr. Eldon John. Thank you.
great is thy faithfulness. At this time, we're going to ask the Honorable Prime Minister, Dr. Terence Drew, to come and give us his tribute at this time. Dr. Drew.
Thank you. Good afternoon, Church. First, let me start by, of course, recognizing the pastor and his directorate here in the church. Well, let me give my sincerest condolences to the mother, father, family, friends, communities, on the passing of Bria. This passing, of course, would have touched many lives. I have known Bria even before she knew herself. Because, of course, I remembered when her mom was pregnant with her. And I remembered also when she was born. And she really contributed to the happiness of her family, the happiness for mom, and those who really were touched by her. She had some challenges, some health challenges that began somewhat early in life. And Bria was a fighter. She never gave up. And I think because Bria was such a fighter, she inspired especially her mother to also fight for her. Many nights at the hospital, many days, and even having to travel overseas when they went to Dominican Republic and some of the experiences that they would have gone through there. Bria came back and the same issue would have recurred, but this time she would have had the opportunity to survive it. As I observed what Bria and her family and her mother went through, it was really difficult to accept that she couldn't get all of the treatment that she could have been afforded because there were two significant barriers. One, because of the expense, and secondly, to access a center that could treat Bria's condition. And really her situation inspired me more to really speak about a policy that would have really benefited Bria, but would have benefited a lot of other children. And so the policy where I said that any child who gets sick, that the country would take care of their medical bills if they had to go overseas, if it could not be treated here, was in a great way inspired by the experience that I myself also went through with Bria. I could not understand why a country would not support children to live if there were the possibility. And so she inspired that. And today I want to say that we now have a fund in the government that any child who is sick, it does not matter the financial background, if the parents can't afford it, there will be no delay in that treatment because they will be fully supported. But she did not only inspire that aspect of the policy, but then one of the first discussions I had with the American ambassador when I met her was about children who were sick. Because I knew that Carissa wanted to take Bria to the United States. And there were some barriers blocking her, where I felt that she would have gotten good treatment. And one of the first things that I discussed with the American ambassador, and I'm saying it publicly for the record as well, because the ambassador, Her Excellency, would know that this is one of the first things I brought up with her. I said, our people have to apply for visa. What if we have children who are sick and the United States really offers the best hope for them? What mechanisms we can put in place to make sure that that child can get to the U.S. as quickly as possible and get the treatment that he or she needs. And we put two things in place. She gave me somebody who is in direct contact with me, who I can contact anytime, so that the child can go almost immediately. And then the other barrier would have been what would be the source of funding. And I simply told her that the government of St. Kitts and Nevis will be the source of funding. And with those two things, even the Bria has gone, the policies that she inspired would really help children who would someday find themselves in the situation that she found herself, to no fault of hers. And Bria died, I think, a week before that policy was able to be implemented. My only hope was that she could have lived until the 5th or 6th of August. But it was not meant to be, and so Bria has gone on. And I want to say to her mom and to the family that she has gone, and it's difficult to deal with. I don't pretend that I understand. But what Bria has done, she has inspired policies that would help little children who will come after her. And so I pray for her soul to rest in eternal peace, and to say to the parents, I don't have all the answers, but you have my support. God bless. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Prime Minister. And we'll continue now as the godparents come and do their tribute.
Thank you.
time we're going to stand and sing When Mothers of Salem as the ushers lift the offering for this afternoon. So let's stand. Ushers, could you please prepare to lift the offerings for us, please? When mothers of Salem their children brought to Jesus, the Sunday disciples drove them back and bid them to depart. But Jesus saw them in heaven, sweetly smile, kindly said, suffer little children to come on, for I will receive them and fold them in my bosom. I'll be a shepherd to your land. bless the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you thanks for the gifts that was received, and we pray a special blessing upon everyone who gave today. May this work continue to flourish and to do what you've put it here to do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. You may be seated. And this time we will have a slideshow of Bria. This time we'll get the eulogy by Amber Amory.
Good afternoon, church. Bria Miracle Diane Kelencia Arthurton was born on Sunday, 23rd September 2018, weighing a surprising 2 pounds. She had a 6-week stay at the hospital where she amazed her nurses and doctor. How could this baby strive so efficiently in her state? She was always on the alert whenever it was eating time. I mean, that was definitely one of her favorite things to do. That small baby fitting into both palms would move around in her incubator having a grand time. There was this one nurse, Stephanie Lewis, that grew to be one of her biggest cheerleaders. After seeing the bond between them both, her mother, Kenricia Georges, only saw it fit to not let it end there. Nurse Lewis inherited the role of a godmother. It was only fair. After being able to leave the hospital, Bria and her mother stayed with her great aunt for environmental reasons until her immune system grew strong enough for where she would then reside. Whenever her mommy had to run errands while residing with Aunt Joyce, the teachers at the Louisa Grant Preschool were always there, ready to assist in caring for her until the task of her mother was over. Fast forward to January 2019, Bria was admitted to the hospital for breathing complications, where she was administered oxygen around the clock. Her growth journey was miraculous. Who would have thought, after her very own wipes kit could shadow her, that she would become such an inspirational giant? Our miracle grew so strong, she was able to attend the Blessings Daycare. She was a quiet yet sweet child. That little girl would be so attentive at her school sessions and only displayed what she learned at home. It was always funny because teacher Tishani would say, "Bria is so quiet, she does not utter a word." Little did she know that child was a whole sponge. Everything was okay until the end of the year 2020 in November, when we experienced a horrible scare where she vomited blood and had to be rushed to the emergency room and had to be admitted. There was no diagnosis until January 2021 after having a repeated relapse. An endoscopy was done by Dr. Cameron Wilkinson, where he discovered varicose veins in Bria's esophagus. This disease, esophageal varices, continued to taunt her little body until she was able to travel to Santo Domingo to receive treatment in April of the said year. She endured 7 procedures and over 10 blood transfusions at that time. Trust when I say she was a strong little warrior. It had gotten so bad at one point where Bria had a severe relapse only days after the last set of procedures. It got Aunt Joy so scared, never witnessing such an incident, causing a rise in her pressure. She then had to head back home in order for her to get treated. That situation left baby Bria and mommy alone awaiting the pending case. Having thought that it was over, Bria and her mommy were able to return to their national soil. However, I'd like to share a joke with you. On arrival, 2 weeks after quarantine, Auntie Joyce came to visit. Bria was adamant and not talking to her. She probably told herself they were yin and yang, and Auntie ran with a bang. All she knew was she was loved and Auntie should have stayed. It used to be the facial expressions for me whenever she would sternly ignore our dear Aunt Joyce. If you think that was bad, she used to fight and win, holding back smiles from her Auntie Kim when she would run in the arms of her brother, Prince, and her uncles, Kiwi and Rasan. She loved those guys as much as she did cooked food before it became harmful to her. Her Aunt Mona's affectionate and contagious smile would always defeat Bria. She always stood firm, even in her loss. Bria was spoiled beyond measure, and she used it to her advantage. She was very smart and knew exactly how to manipulate her siblings. It was her way or the highway. All she had to shout was, "Mommy is Prince. Mommy is Nene." We would all have a laugh because she was just too smart for her own good. Her grandmother, who she identified as Mommy, would always allow Bria her own way until, for some reason, her granny told her she would lash her, and Bria replied, "Mommy, you can't lash me." Some may find it rude, however, Granny was not expecting that response and could do nothing else than to laugh. Then there's Dwayne Strawn, the manager at our local Mass Assist, who wholeheartedly entered and stayed in Bria's life. Whenever he would visit, she would run to the door and holler Strawn in her little voice. She would run to the car, and he would not hesitate to let her have her way. She was also very stubborn. Whenever Bria would visit her mother's godie Vanessa, it would be hell to tell the priest. For whatever reason, making it hard for her great-godmother was pleasing. She'd enjoy the little bribes, even for just a goodbye. She would peep and smirk whenever Godie wasn't looking because she loved to be the center of attention. What was worst was when clients came in the office, she became full of life, and she would look at Godie with a daring stare. I guess that's how she showed her love. She behaved the same way with her great aunt, Alana. Funny enough, her aunt was lucky to get one goodbye and a few smiles. Miracle was a really tough cookie. Might I add, she always had an accent of the USA, only traveling to the Dominican Republic. It was always a breath of fresh air hearing her speak, especially with her health causing restrictions from her attending school. Her mother was very protective of her. Even for her to have a fall, KK would rant, "Give me my child," as if she forgot Bria belonged to everyone as well. Bria would then go right back at it because all she knew was strength. She was an expressive child, knew exactly what she wanted and when. She enjoyed watching her favorite shows, namely Trash Truck, Paw Patrol, Peppa Pig, Coco Melon, and Gabby's Dollhouse. Whenever her tablet died, Bria would blow the roof of the house, and her grandmommy would then hand her television to her. Very spoiled, if you ask me. She was also a little fashionista. She loved dressing up and taking pictures. She would also wait till everyone was asleep at night and have her own studio time taking pictures and videos of herself. Trust me when I say, waking up the next morning each day to see her new work was refreshing. She was that sweet little girl. After publicly expressing the agony baby Bria continued to endure, an army of good Samaritans rose in aid to try and preserve Bria's little life. The pictures circulated touched more hearts than a case of kisses chocolate. The family then began to see some sort of light. Bria would be saved. Her mother grew desperately determined, where she reached out to the office of the Honorable Prime Minister, Mia Motley of Barbados, where the Honorable displayed selflessness, and she too also came on board to help our baby girl. However, around 2 a.m. on Saturday, 30th July, Nene, the first princess, woke her mother with a gentle rub in order to alert her on what was taking place. Bria had another episode. You know what's funny, though? Bria was very affectionate, and that Friday night before, her mother experienced extra love. It was as if she was assuring her dear mommy. After the exchanges of the I love yous, Bria covered her mother with her favorite blanket and kissed her forehead. Continuing to relapse, her mother took her and cleaned her up. Her mother alerted her amazing doctor, Dr. Yannick Henry, who arrived at the hospital in no time. This man was flash. They stabilized her and admitted her to the ward. The Saturday ran so smoothly. She was as bright as the stars on a cloudless night. She and her mommy played and loved on each other. Bria even fed herself. She looked so strong. On Sunday, 31st July, 2022, around 6 a.m., Bria's behavior was abnormal. She was experiencing severe pains while still not being able to wake properly. The nurse came and treated her, and if there's one thing I'd admit, her nurses were always, and I mean always, efficient. The entire team of peds and maternity, along with her amazing doctor, Yannick Henry, please give them a round of applause. Fought for her to the very end. Unfortunately, Bria's body grew tired and her father called her home. The family would love to thank each and everyone who has contributed to her welfare, whether through prayers or donations. We wholeheartedly thank the team at JNF who have been extremely supportive throughout her entire life. Friends, family, and well-wishers, let us all stand in honor of Bria and have a brief moment of silence. Please stand. You may now be seated. Thank you.
Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. You know, the Bible says, no man liveth unto himself. No matter how small or no matter how young we are, no matter how old we are allowed to go, no man liveth unto himself. And that young little life has touched so many persons here today. We're going to share a quick word with you this afternoon. But before we do that, just let me extend my condolences again to the family, to the mother, grandmother, and all the other members of the family of Bria. Want you to know that we here at the People's Evangelistic Center has been praying for you and will continue to pray for you. God is not dead, He is alive, and He has what it takes to take you through this phase of your life. There's a verse I want to read for you from 2 Samuel. 2 Samuel chapter 12, verse 23. But now he is dead. Wherefore should I fast? Can I bring him again? I shall go to him, but he shall not return to me. And this afternoon, for the next few moments, I would like to share from this story, a story that I believe most of you might be familiar, if not all, but it's a story that tells us a lot of stuff, has a lot of rich stuff in it, and if you look at it good, you would be able to draw something, especially in times like these. But what's happening here in this chapter? David had gotten one of his soldiers' wife pregnant. The child was born, and God was displeased. And God sent a prophet to tell him that the child was going to die. The Bible says that he fasted and he prayed. He fasted and he prayed. He laid in the ground. He didn't want no music. He didn't want no special food or anything. He just went without the necessities of life. But after 7 days, the Bible says that the child died. And when the child died, the servants became very disturbed because they said, how in the world can we tell King David that the child is dead? The moment that child got sick, he has been walking up and down, lying down in the floor, talking to God, not wanting the specialties of the palace. And how in the world can we tell him now that the child is dead? So they decided to shushu, as we would say, among each other. But David picked up what was going on. They were his servants. They was working for him. So he had an idea how they behaved on a regular basis. So he realized that something was wrong. And he asked, is the child dead? And they said yes. But what happened stunned all of them. Because after he heard that the child was dead, the Bible says he took off his sackcloth. That's the clothes that he was wearing when he was fasting, when he was laying in the ground. He took it off and he says, I'm going to have me a nice bubble bath. And he went and got some of his, you know, famous perfumes and dumped it in that bath and went and he had himself a nice bath. And all the servants, they are amazed of his behavior. And he got dressed. He got some of the best smelling perfume. You know, the king always has the best, I would assume, you know, under normal circumstances. So he went and he got some of the best perfume that he had and he sprayed himself up and he dressed up. And as he was going to the door, you know, I'm paraphrasing, so you understand me. As he's going to the door, the servants asked, where are you going? He said, I'm going to church. To church? He says, yes, I am going to church. And when I come back from church, I want you to have a leg of pork for me. I want you to have a leg of mutton for me. I want you to have a macaroni pie for me. I want you to have a corn pie for me. I want you to have a pot of rice. And we're going to have a ball. You understanding me? In other words, when I come back from church, I am going to rejoice. And they said, you're crazy, king. Your child is just dead. Your child just died. You've been mourning for this child for these days, and this is how you're going to do it? That's what brings us to this verse. He says, you know, he has gone. He's not coming back. I have the ability to go to him. And that's what we want to look at today. Amen. Bria's gone. Bria's gone. And she's not coming back in this life, on this side. But the thing about it is because we are alive, God has made it possible so that you and I can go to be with her. Amen. Every time you have a funeral, people always wonder. Sometimes they ask, and sometimes, even they don't ask, you know what they're thinking. I wonder if he make it to heaven, boy. I wonder where he went. You know, especially if he or she was a kind of funny person. You know, some people just bad. But you hope that at the end of the day, they're sleeping somewhere. But we all wonder. But we don't have to wonder about a child. We don't have to wonder. We sang the song which spoke to children being jewels of Christ. And that's what the disciples couldn't understand. When the mothers brought the children to him to bless them, they couldn't understand why Jesus would take time with little children when you had so much adults around him trying to find out what it's going to take me to get rid of my wife. What it's going to take me to get rid of my husband. That's what was happening, you know. That is what was happening right then and there. And the disciples couldn't figure out, here is these adults trying to find out how to live, how to keep it going. And Jesus puts them down, rests them down, and takes time for these children. Jesus treasures children. Now let's look at the story that we have before us. David said, he's gone. He's gone. And I am not. He's not coming back. Now there are different beliefs with different religions in the world about the end of time. Some people feel that when our time comes, like Bria, and we breathe the final breath, one day we're going to come back like a rat, or like a monkey, or like a dog. If you've never heard it before, it's a reality. Some people literally believe that. Some people think that you can do what you want, when you want, how you want, and when your time comes to die, all you need to do is make sure you leave enough money with who is behind so they can get you into the right place. They say you pay the priests, the pastors, depending on the type of church. We got different names. I'm a pastor, I'm a priest, I'm a prophet. You understand me? But the belief is that once you have enough money, you can be able to pay your way through. Lord, some people think because we could do it in life, we can do it in debt. Amen. You know, some of us are not in life. Some of us, where we are, we don't really belong there. Could I talk to you today? Money is what got us where we are. Amen. But some people think because we can trick our way through life, scheme our way through life, do funny things as we go through life to get up to where we think we should be, we can do it at the end of the day. That's how some people think. Some people believe, and this was the belief of that man who hung on the cross with Jesus. Somehow he believed that Jesus had, first of all, he believed that Jesus was supreme, in a sense where he was overall. He had a certain amount of authority. Even though he was hanging on a cross, even though he was beaten by the Roman soldiers, even though they spat on him, even though they called him all kind of names, one of those men who hung on the cross with him somehow believed that this man was more than who he was. So he referred to him as Lord. Lord. The second thing is that he recognized that this man had a kingdom. This man had a place to go after he died. Now, when you look at this little story within there, if this man had embraced what he expressed on the cross, he would have never been on the cross. If this man had put what he really believed in his life, or what he believed when he was hanging on the cross, if he had put that to work in his life when he was living, he would have never been on the cross, because he had done something wrong. One portion referred to him as a malefactor, another one referred to him as a thief, and sometimes we give them all kind of names. But the thing about it is that they were in trouble with the government. Amen. Amen. That's why they ended up on the cross. But he said, Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom. In other words, in spite of all the beliefs, in spite of all the things that he had heard while he was living, he realized, this man who I am hanging next to, he is Lord. He has authority, and he has somewhere to go, an enduring kingdom. That this death can't stop him from inheriting. And he said, Lord, remember me. In other words, this man believed that we can only get to heaven through Jesus Christ. David said, he's gone. He's not coming back. I have the ability now to go and be with him. Now, how do we get from here to there? How do we get from here to there? Jesus said in St. John, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. You see, Jesus, up until this point, every time he spoke to his disciples, he said, whatever you see me do, I'm doing it because my Father told me to do it. Whatever you hear me say, I'm saying it because my Father told me to say it. I am doing you. When you see me, you see my Father. My actions represents my Father. But he pulled them together one day because he realized that time was running out. And he said, I don't want your heart to be troubled. I have taught you to believe in God up until this point. Now, I got something to tell you, and I want you to believe in me. You believe what I had to tell you about God, my Father. Now, I want you to believe what I have to tell you as his son. He says, in my Father's house are many mansions. Many mansions. We have a lot of Bibles that have been rewritten over, and they change it to be able to help, you know, to help us understand it better. And one of them that I don't really like is that this version says, in my Father's house are many dwelling places. You know, it makes it sound small, but the original says, in my Father's house are many mansions. He says, I'm going to prepare a place for you. And I love this part of this encounter here. Because when we are building in life, some of us inherit homes. We buy homes that has been already built. And when we get in there, the bedrooms are too small. The kitchen is too small. The roof is too low. So we got to lick out and rise up and stretch out and everything. But when something is prepared for you, when you are building a house for you, you know how big you want your kitchen. You know how much pot you to use on that counter. You ain't want a little piece of counter. You want a long counter. Amen. You know how much pies you make, so you prepare it for you. And Jesus says, I am going to prepare a place for you. Tell somebody, just for you. Come on, tell somebody, don't be afraid. Just for you. I'm going to prepare a place for you. He says, I want to be with you. I want you to be with me. If it were not so, I would have told you. Thomas, you know that fellow Thomas, we refer to him as a doubting Thomas. And he jumps up and he says, yeah. You're talking about mansion and you're going to be pure. We ain't know where you're going, you know. How we got another way? Jesus says. Help me somebody. Jesus said what? I am the way. I am the way. He went on and he told him at another point. He says, no man cometh unto the Father but by me. You can't get through Jesus through your church. You can't get through Jesus through your money. You can't get through Jesus because of who you are, your pedigree. No. We only come to God through Jesus Christ. We only get where Bria has gone through Jesus Christ. David was a king. We read his writings. We are familiar of his stories, his experiences with God. But I believe this experience did something for David that nothing else would have done. When that child died, apart from, well, of course, everything is symbolic, but I'm not going to take the time to go through everything. But he went to church. He went to church. That's what I want to use. Why should we go to church after a loss? Why should we go to church after having a baby for 3 years? After having this problem and that, why should I go to church? I believe David went to church to look back on his life. Number one, he remembered his mistakes. He repented before God. And number two, I believe he went to give God thanks for the time. Those years that you spent with Bria, the parents, and the rest of you who knew her personally, those are years you would never forget. They might not be like some of your other children and grandchildren, but those are years that you would never forget. And those are times where you can say, God, thank you. We had hoped that she would be around. We had hoped that she would still be here. We had hoped that we would see her move from preschool to kindergarten to high school and all of us, but she's not here, but thank you. There's so many mothers who have, so many women who have never had a child. There's so many fathers who were never blessed to be able to hold a child. But you gave her to us for a period of time. And Lord, I thank you. Amen. You see, it's not only thanking God for the lot of money. It's not only about thanking God for the big house and the fancy car. It's not only thanking God for all those children whom you've seen grown up and has a job and be able to bring back money. But it's be able to thank God even when things don't work out like you had dreamed. David, he went to church, and I believe that experience did something for him that no other experience did for him. There was one time when he left his hometown and he went out to do battle. And when he came back, the town where he lived was burnt. The women were taken. The children was taken, the men was killed. And the men who was with him, the Bible says, they wept like little children. He had to pull himself together because they almost stoned him. But what happened is that he encouraged himself in the Lord. And he prayed to God, and God says, go after them. And he went out and he recovered everything that they had taken. I'm using this reference to let you know that there were some great moments in the life of David. But I believe this, and I'm going to call it a little, this little one drove him back to church. drove him back to the house of God. And I want to encourage the parents, the family, the friends. Don't become bitter against God. Don't become bitter against doctors. Don't become bitter against nobody. Go back to God. Let this be an experience that will draw you back to God. Take off your mourning clothes. Understand me. You know, I know we gotta feel funny. I mean, we gotta mourn. That's a part of life. But when he took off his sackcloth, it was symbolic of changing what you was wearing, what had you down, what make you look the way you look. Take it off. Go back to God. When he took it off, he put on something fresh and he went to church. When you come to church, God has the ability to put the Spirit of God in you. God has the ability to lift you out of your times of mourning. He said he's going to give you, the oil of joy for mourning. Remember, she is gone. And we will go. Let us live a life so that when we go, we meet her on the other side. May God bless you, and may her soul rest in peace. Amen. Let's all stand. We're going to pray, and then I'm going to ask Miss Hodge, I hope she's still here, the lady who sang earlier, to come and lead us in the final song. Is she still here? Virgil Hart, she's still here? Okay. All right. Well, let's pray. Oh, she left. Okay. All right. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we give you thanks for this afternoon. We thank you for allowing Bria to come to spend the time that she spent with us. We thank you for the joys that was experienced. We look at the photos, and God, we only imagine the great time, the parents and the rest of the family. We listen to the eulogy, and God, we want to say thank you for the time that you allowed her to be here. We pray for everyone who've come today. And God, if they hear nothing else, please help them to remember. She is gone. We will go one day. May we prepare our hearts. May we prepare our lives. May we fix ourselves in such a way so one day we would hear, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant, enter into the joys of the Lord." And for that we thank you. We pray that you would continue to comfort the parents and the rest of the family. God, help them to look to you for strength. No one else in this world can give strength like you can. And God, for that we bless you. Bless everyone who have come to celebrate with them today the life of little Bria. May the blessings of God continue to rest upon us all. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. Bless the Lord. Let's go back to our hymn sheets now. And we'll do that last song. I'm not familiar with it. Anybody familiar with this wants to lead this for me? I enjoy hearing it, but I know that Noel. Oh. Anybody? Oh, who? You coming? Huh? Mona? Okay. Come on quickly. Ramona is going to come and lead us in this song, and then we're going to go. When we get down, we're going to allow the Honorable Prime Minister to leave. and then we would leave after. Please remain where you are as we allow at the appropriate time the Honorable Prime Minister to leave, and then we would follow. You know?
Love incarnate, love divine. Star and angels give the sign. Bow to babe on bended knees. The savior of humanity. On thank you.
Yeah. Sir. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. He cometh forth like a flower and is cut down. He fleeth also as a shadow and continueth not. Lord, make me to know mine end and the measure of my days, what it is, that I may know how frail I am. Behold, thou hast made my days as an handbreadth, and my age is as nothing before thee. Verily, every man at his best state is altogether vanity. We come to lay to rest the body of this child, to give back to the earth all that which is of the earth. We do so knowing that she is in the presence of God. For Jesus taught us that unless we turn and become like little children, we will never enter the kingdom of heaven. In our sorrow, may we still see God's care, both for us and for him, for her, through though he has gone where we may not reach. He has not gone beyond the loving care and touch of God. Heaven grows more real day every day as our loved ones go on before us. For as much as it has pleased Almighty God, it is wise providence to take out of this wall the soul of this child. We therefore commit her body to the ground. Earth to earth, ash to ash, dust to dust, looking for the resurrection at the last day and the life of the world to come through Jesus Christ our Lord. As whose coming to judge the world, the earth, and the sea shall give up their dead, and the bodies of those who slept in him shall be changed and be made like his glorious body, according to the power by which he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, again we give you thanks for the life of this child. We come to celebrate the few short years that you bless the parents and the rest of the family with. And God, as we stand here today, we ask that you would burn it in our consciences that one day someone will stand here echoing those same words over us. We ask God that you would remember everyone that's here. Help us to live our lives in such a way, so when our time comes to leave this world, we would be able to hear, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant." Bless everyone who've come to celebrate the life of this child. Continue to remember the parents and the rest of the family. God, we ask for a special touch and blessings upon them. Help them to put their trust completely in you. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen. Listen. Let's turn to our hymn sheets and sing, "Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but we are strong. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. For the Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me still today, walking with me on my way, wanting as a friend to give light and love to all who live. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. For the Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me, he who died heaven's gate to open wide. He will wash away my sin. Let his little child come in. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. For the Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me, he will stay close beside me all the way. Thou hast bled and died for me. I will henceforth live for thee. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. For the Bible tells me so. Just below that one, we have this little light of mine. I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine. All the time. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine all the time. Don't let Satan, don't let Satan blow it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Don't let Satan blow it out. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine all the time. This little light of mine, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine all the time. Put it under a bushel, put it under a bushel, no, I'm gonna let it shine. Put it under a bushel, no, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Oh, this little light of mine, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine all the time. Let it shine till Jesus comes, let it shine till Jesus comes. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine till Jesus comes. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine all the time. This little light, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine all the time. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Oh, this little light of mine, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine all the time. When mothers of Salem, their children brought to Jesus, the stern disciples drove them back and bid them to depart. But Jesus saw them ere they fled, sweetly smiled and kindly said, suffer the little children to come unto me. When mothers of Salem their children brought to Jesus, the stern disciples drove them back and bid them to depart. But Jesus saw them ere they fled, and sweetly God smiled and kindly said, suffer little children to come unto me, for I will receive them and fold them in my bosom. I'll be a shepherd to those them. Oh, drive them not away, for if their hearts to me they give, they shall with me in glory live. Suffer little children to come unto me. How kind was the Savior to bid those children welcome. But there are many thousands who have never heard his name. The Bible they have never read. They know not what the Savior said. Suffer little children to come on. still a kind Savior. His little children welcome, for Jesus' loving tender heart is to us the same. Go hear their voice from heaven itself. He spreads this word. Suffer little children to come unto me. How kind was the Savior to bid those children welcome, for there are many thousands who have never heard his name. The Bible they have never read. They know not what the Savior said. Suffer little children to come unto me. When he cometh to make up his jewels, all his jewels, precious jewels, his love and his own. When he cometh to make up his jewels, all his jewels, precious jewels, his love and his own.
Like the stars of the morning, his light will never dawning.
They shall shine in their beauty, like gems from his crown.
Little children,
whom love their Redeemer, are the jewels, precious jewels, his love and his own. Like the stars of the morning, his bright crown at dawning, they shall shine in their beauty, like gems for his crown. He will gather the gems for his kingdom, all the pure ones, all the bright ones, his love and his own. Like the stars of the morning, his bright crown adorning, they shall shine in their beauty, like gems for his crown.
Jesus wants me for a sunbeam to shine for him each day. In every way try to please him, at home, at school, at play. A sunbeam, Jesus wants me for a sunbeam. A sunbeam, I'll be a sunbeam for him. Jesus wants me to be loving and kind to all I see, showing how pleasant and happy his little one can be. A sunbeam, Jesus wants me for a sunbeam. A sunbeam, I'll be a sunbeam for him. I will ask Jesus to help me to keep my heart from sin, ever reflecting his goodness and always shine for him. A sunbeam, a sunbeam, Jesus wants me for a sunbeam. A sunbeam, a sunbeam, I'll be a sunbeam for him. I'll be a sunbeam for Jesus, I can if I but try. Serving him moment by moment, then live with him on high. A sunbeam, a sunbeam, Jesus wants me for a sunbeam. A sunbeam, a sunbeam, I'll be a sunbeam for him. A sunbeam, a sunbeam, Jesus wants me for a sunbeam. A sunbeam, a sunbeam, I'll be a sunbeam for him. Whisper a prayer in the morning, whisper a prayer at noon, whisper a prayer in the evening, so keep your hearts in tune. God answers prayer in the morning, God answers prayer at noon, God answers prayer. Come in the morning, Jesus may come at noon, Jesus may come in the evening, so keep your hearts in tune. Whisper, whisper a prayer in the morning, whisper a prayer at noon, whisper a prayer in the evening, so keep your hearts. God answers prayer in the morning, God answers prayer at noon, God answers prayer in the evening, so keep your hearts in tune. Jesus may come in the morning, Jesus may come at noon, Jesus may come in the evening, so keep your hearts in tune. Jesus, Jesus may come in the morning, Jesus may come at noon, Jesus may come in the evening, so keep your hearts in tune. Jesus may come in the evening, so keep your hearts in tune. Jesus may come in the evening, so keep your hearts in
Savior's love.
who died to set me free. He tells me of his precious blood, the sinner's perfectly. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. It tells of one whose living heart can feel my deepest woe. Whose in its trowel bear a path that none can bear below. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. It tells me of a Savior's love who died to set me free. It tells me of his precious blood, the sinner's perfect plea. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. Tells me of one, it tells of one whose loving heart can feel my deepest woe. It tells its sorrow bear a path that none can bear below. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, because he first loved me. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, because he first loved me.
Okay, it's time for us. It's time for us to let a reach now. So we're going to ask all those with reeds to come and begin with the laying of the reeds. The Prime Minister had one, so we're going to begin with his first. And after the Prime Minister's first laying the reeds, then of course the rest of the family. Could you make ready for us, please? Hello, make some ready for us.